our greatest challenge that faces South Africa is how do we deal with unemployment, and my personal passion, how do we deal with the unemployment of young people? We face a few challenges. One of the key ones is the fact that we have a policy situation in South Africa that is incoherent. I think if I speak to many business people, they say to me, we want to trade with South Africa, we want to invest in South Africa. What we are uncertain of is what will South Africa look like a few months or a few years. And I must be honest with you, I face the same frustration. I face the frustration of a lackluster, confused leadership given by the ANC. I face the difficult frustration that on one day we agree that the economic future of South Africa must be expressed by how we use the National Development Plan. And on another day, I come back and I find other people who are saying, no, we're going to take this policy direction. The inconsistencies and the incoherence means that for investors globally, there's no confidence in knowing where South Africa's economic direction is going. If we're going to achieve the economic growth required for us to be able to address the challenge of the unemployed South Africans, we have to settle once and for all that we need a decision on what policy we must take forward. I think without fail, the ANC government has given up on the people of South Africa. Instead of focusing on resources on solving unemployment crisis, I think they caught up in a different program. There's no doubt that South Africa faces a backlog of infrastructure. Our infrastructure development program must be at the forefront of what we do if we are to address the economic inequality that we see. Starting point is here in Gauteng. I was fascinated recently by the fact that the ANC is marching against Eskom, which is the irony of all ironies, as to how a whole organization marches against itself. But here's the thing that will fascinate me even more. I'm still wondering whether they are going to march against e-tolls when South Africans refuse to pay for e-tolls. I want to be crystal clear here today. E-tolls will, like Eskom, create a stranglehold on our economy. Nobody doubts the fact that we must build road infrastructure that is world class. But to triple tax South Africans through that is, quite frankly, a crime and something that's not going to be sustainable for the economy. There's no doubt about the fact that Eskom may give a few of us a candlelit dinner from time to time, but is in fact holding South Africa's economy at hostage. We are clear, ladies and gentlemen, that the relic, this monopolized control over energy, is outdated, unworkable, and certainly not delivering on the economic outcomes of this country. I am of the complete view that if we're really going to address the supply of energy into our economy, we must allow for Eskom to face competition. I'm not in the privatization bandwidth, as Gwede Mantashe seems to be confused about. But we have to allow for Eskom to manage the build program, and we must take the grid away from them. If we do that, we'll be able to include new players, players that can produce energy, whether they use of coal or the use of gas or the use of other wind energy. If we don't allow that competition to take place, Eskom will continue to hold us ransom. South Africa's future can only be sustainable if we say to ourselves that at least the number of small businesses must be on the increase. We cannot simply be a nation of employees. We must be a nation of employers. And rather than talking about 5 million jobs, it's better for us to talk about 1 million entrepreneurs.